Hello, here's a piece of metal for the upper knife guide. This piece is for mounting the lower knife, and the small one for the gear lever. The flat bars are thick to ensure adequate strength of the plant gear transmission. I mark the position of the teeth on the upper guide using a compass. While using a center patch, I evenly mark the maximum lower edge of the cutout, which I made with a drill of the appropriate thickness. After drilling the holes, I mark the edges of the teeth using a template and a scraper. Then I drilled a ready hole for mounting the knife, and now I use the hole to make a semicircular outer edge of the teeth with an appropriately mounted angle grinder. The next step was to cut the teeth according to the previously marked edges. Due to the need to obtain cutting edges perpendicular to the surface of the flat bar, I use a guide for an angle grinder for this purpose. In the case of the gear wheel, I first drill a ready hole, then mounted it in a vise, and on the table a holder for the marker and marked a circle. After cutting off the excess metal, I evenly marked the lower maximum edge of the tooth cut out with the same marker. After drilling the holes on the bench drill, all that was left was to cut the teeth according to the previous marking with an angle grinder with a thin disc. Then I leveled the outer edges of the teeth with an angle grinder in the way you see in the video. Here is a piece of old pipe that served as the lever handle. It required dirty cleaning. Normally it wouldn't be worth doing, but when I took into account the time that would be necessary to buy a new pipe, I decided to fight with this old thing. This is what the finished semicircle of the gear lever looks like. And this is how the clean pipe looks before welding. Here's the upper knife guide with the gear transmission made. All that remains is to weld a small piece of metal to obtain the desired shape. I made the cutting knives from an old plow mold board. The material was not super hard, because it was possible to strengthen the cut strips of material, drill holes and thread them. And this is what the lower knife guide looks like after drilling holes and threading small holes. Large holes are used to screw the knife with the possibility of moving it, while small holes allow for the appropriate positioning of the lower knife in relation to the upper knife. Thanks to such assembly, the tool tolerates different knife thicknesses to a small extent. The lower guide, all that remains is to weld a base supporting the lower knife from below, and weld both guides together. And this is what the tool looks like ready for use. The guillotine was mounted in such a way that it was possible to cut large sheets of metal and to quickly unscrew it and allow the table to be used for other activities. And this is how you cut sheet metal made with this guillotine. I'm Silvestro. I invite you to like and comment on the video. I invite you to subscribe to my YouTube channel and watch other films.